Say you have a really cool app idea and you want to make it happen, but you don't want to spend thousands of dollars on a developer. Is it possible to do something for $250? Today I'm going to show you that it can be done. Maybe a little bit more. Let's just say a budget of $5. I'm going to show you how to hire an amazing, amazing developer for a budget of less than $5.
Nice.
I guess what I said is a little bit clickbaity because we're not really hiring a real person to do this coding for you, but we're hiring an AI developer called Claude Dev. And he's so incredibly smart, intelligent, and he works really, really fast. Okay, so we're gonna get started right away. And by the end of this video, I hope you're inspired to take action and actually build that app yourself. You built this for $2.50. We're going to build an expense tracker app using Claude Dev. This is the agenda for today. We're gonna give a quick intro to learn more about Claude Dev and installing it into Cursor, then actually building the app and deploying it. What is Claude Dev? Claude Dev is basically an open source project by this developer over here. You can follow him on Twitter, and it can handle complex software development tasks step by step. It's like an AI assistant, right, that helps you code without you needing to actually code. And it can execute command, read file, write to file, inspect a site and search files and all that good stuff. Basically, it just does a lot of the coding for you. And why do people like it? Because it can do chained actions, it has caching features, so it saves some token, meaning it's more efficient so the AI doesn't have to rebuild its context because it's already there. And I like it because it shows you exactly how many token you spend on a particular command and how much you've spent. Also, the creator seems to be adding features really quickly, and it's a little community. One really important thing to note is that with Claude Dev, you do have to have your own API key to an AI model in order to use Claude Dev, because I already subscribed to ChatGPT and Claude, so I already have the API keys. So I've been testing around with Claude Dev, but it does cost extra money. Unlike Cursor, there's a basic tier from Cursor that you could just run with it without subscribing to anything. This is the table I made to compare and contrast Claude Dev versus Cursor Composer. I think it is a little bit more technical for the non-technical people, but I think it's still really easy to use, and I'm sure you can learn it really quickly too. What we're going to do today is actually install Claude Dev into Cursor so you can use both at the same time. Steps to installing Claude Dev onto Cursor. So first, you actually have to download Visual Studio Code. If you don't already have it, just go to download and choose whatever version you want to. By the way, I mentioned Cursor a lot in this tutorial. If you don't know what it is, do watch my very first video on what is Cursor and how do you use it. You should be able to see something like this. And right here, this is where the extensions are. You need to search for Claude Dev right here, and you will see a bunch of things. But this is the one we want, the one that has this robot looking thing. Once you download and install it, then you need to go and open up Cursor. So you can go to Command Space, open up Cursor. You can either open a folder or whatnot, but so here I'm going to make directory and create a folder for myself. I'm just going to say tracker, well, whatever. So, and then I'm going to cd into x tracker. And so now this is my folder. I have this x tracker app right now. So now that I open up Cursor, and you can see over here that I already installed it. But if you haven't, the first time you have to go to the search part and type in this right pointing caret, or the other way to do it is command shift. It's the same thing as inputting the caret. And then what you need to do is search for import VS Code extensions and settings and just click enter, and it should automatically import everything for you. You can go to extensions to make sure that it has been installed. Technically, you're supposed to be able to install it here, but I couldn't do it in Cursor. And now you can go back to Command-Shift-P or go on the search bar again and then search for Claude. And you should be able to see this option here that says show Claude Dev. And then we're going to click on it and you will see this left-hand panel. I already ran some commands before because I was testing it. And so you see that here, it will show you how many tokens I used and the API cost for me. To set it up, you first need to select an API provider. They do recommend Anthropic, which is Claude, right? I happen to already have it, so I just inputted my Anthropic API key. You can include any custom instructions you want. I just hit done, and then you should be able to start typing your task here. So I'm going to say this is a brand new project. Can you help me create an expense tracker using next.js with app router? And then let's just see what it comes up with, right? So now it's going to run the command for you. So it's going to say, okay, you need to do this. And then you just run the, you just press run command. It's asking me some questions over here in the terminal. I'm just going to put no. You do have to do a little bit of work on the right hand side where the terminal is, and now it's running some API request, and see how it cost me almost 3 cents to run this. And now it says Claude wants to edit this file. I'm going to click save. I'm just going to do whatever it tells me to do for now, and then you can see here it's loading localhost 3000. So what we can do is now we can go to localhost 3000. Now you have this expense tracker, right? You could input, I bought bread for $2 and today's date. Okay, then I'm going to add expense. Now you have this expense tracker here. Let's keep going and see what else Claude Dev is suggesting. You can read about what it's doing. It's also a very good tool to teach you coding and what they're doing. Now it's asking to execute this command, proceed round running. So now it's saying that Claude wants to inspect this website. This is the thing that I thought was really cool that I didn't see in cursor. You can see with this, for this task, I spent almost 7 cents so far. Imagine you're hiring a developer and you're paying him a wage to do this. I guess this is still much cheaper than hiring a human, right? What you can see here is that Claude actually is showing a picture of the website of what I have. It's rendering correctly in place. However, we can make some improvements to enhance the user interface and user experience. See, it says add a background color to the main container for visual separation. I was going to complain about that, and it just did it for me. Next, it says improve the styling of the expense list item. 3, add a total expense calculation. It's not just doing what you're telling it to do, but it's thinking about what you might want. So this is really cool. I'm going to click save. And again, I'm going to let it do whatever it wants to do. The whole task so far, I spent 13 cents. We can go back to our localhost to see what it did. Let's see if it rendered correctly. I'm going to do bread again. I think the font is still not ideal, and I think the date should be default to today, and add expense. $12 for bread. What kind of bread is this? I don't know. Then I'm going to approve. It's checking to make sure the application is fully functional, and now it's running more API requests. And at any point in time after it's done running, you can give some feedback. I don't know if you have, but the other video I have on Replete is also something similar to this, but Claude Dev has more flexibility than Replete. I spent almost a quarter now. It's saying working as expected, looks clean, add a few more features to enhance the user experience, add the ability to delete expenses, implement expense categorization, add a simple chart to visualize expense by category. That sounds great. Change the font so it's black and darker for better readability. I'm going to tell it what to do. See, all the code is right here. So while it's doing all that, it's actually creating the code on the side. And you can see all your files right here, what Claude has created. Go back to Claude Dev. Now we're saving. It's making all the updates for us. Claude Dev seems so great, and I'm very happy with it. It just costs money, but I like the transparency of knowing how much I'm spending. It looks like we've made the necessary changes to fix the import issues. It's inspecting again. I'm going to do approve. See here, it's already viewing it. I'm just going to check it out. Bread, $3. And today, food at expense. Now the font you saw earlier, that the font looks better. It's darker. I still think there are some improvements. This is using our local storage. I think there's some improvements. I want the date to be set to default to today's date and the categories to retain what user last inputted it. And then I'm gonna just, for the heck of it, try using Supabase. For those that don't know, Supabase is basically a Firebase alternative. So you can use Supabase for a backend. You can use GitHub to sign up. I'm just gonna do that. Let's go back to cursor. Okay, save, save. I think you do need to be a little bit technical to know this part, because now it's asking you to input this. And to get these, what you need to do is you need to go to Supabase and you just need to go to create a project, expense tracker, create a new project. Once your project is created, you should be able to see this information over here. You just have to copy it and paste it in cursor. I'm running into a little bit of a problem because it did say that, hey, number of request tokens. I keep running into this. I wish there's a workaround around this, but there isn't so far. So I'm just going to wait a bit and then retry. Okay, great. It looks like Supabase have been successfully added to the file. Let's verify by checking the expense tracker and making sure it can fetch. So this is giving you instructions and you actually have to work with it. You need to copy this and then go back to your Supabase dashboard to do this. Go to the SQL editor and then run. Success. No roles returned. So now it's success. Now we've spent 51 cents. Let's do this. Save. Okay. API request failed. Again, I'm reaching the number of tokens, so I have to wait a little bit. While I'm waiting, I'm gonna go over here, refresh, add expense, and I added this. Now I'm gonna go to Supabase and see if it's here. It added this entry onto Supabase. Technically, I can make this app live now that it has a working database and whatnot. And if you're just using it for yourself, it's sufficient. Trader Joe's ad expense. It's there. So this is live. And I think we're very close to being done. We just need to deploy the app somehow. So let's retry after this. Looks good to me. I realized that we need to add authentication. Can you help me add authentication to allow multiple users to track the expenses? And then let's use Supabase. Exceeded your per limit rate. While we're waiting for this, I want to show you that you can actually select open router. If it runs out of limit, maybe you could use open router, which I have an account to, but I don't really want to switch back and forth because I think there's probably still some context switching that occurs, economically speaking. That doesn't make sense. Now, again, you need to copy this and run it inside Supabase. Cool editor. Just type this and then run. Success. Mind you still have to do this even if you hire a developer. So for this to cost 90 cents, it's super impressive. I just hate the waiting. I hope Anthropic will up my per minute and the day limit. I exceeded my daily token rate. This is so annoying.
This is a secret message that only people who are watching up until this point are seeing. I'm so thankful for you to be with me in this journey. I started this channel because I was really interested in learning more about AI and I wanted to throw myself in there. And the best way to learn is actually to teach somebody, people say. So that's why I'm running this channel. This is my third video. So I'm so thankful that somebody is actually watching this. And if you're watching this, you will make my day if you just leave a comment below with this secret message. I'm just wondering if anybody would actually do that.
Well, because I already hit my daily limit, I guess now it's time to try out OpenRouter. OpenRouter basically lets you use a variety of model, and I already have the API key. I just need to select that. Done. Now let's retry. Okay, well, it worked. It just cost a lot more for whatever reason. Okay, let's keep going. Well, I guess it's a nice thing that you could use other tools. It does feel like it's a little bit more expensive. See, this just quickly jumped up. Is it more expensive? I'm hoping that this would cost me less than $2. I guess my $2 is gonna exceed because this is getting way more expensive than before when I was just using Claude. Let's see, how much was it before? Before, each query was like a penny or something, 5 cents. I never saw something that was that steep. For the sake of completing the project, I will pay a quarter. I noticed that once I switched to OpenRouter, it's just so much more expensive to run this. Okay, now I have this expense tracker. Sign up. Check your email for your confirmation link. Now I can see that my user ID is here and that I typed in this item. So now this is a live app. It is actually working. And I'm sure I can do a lot to improve the UI and UX. But I think this is good enough for now. And now I'm going to deploy the app, okay? Okay, now I already spent $4 because of the deployment. But I actually don't think I need to use AI to do the deployment. I'm just going to follow the directions as I know it to deploy to GitHub and then deploy it onto Vercel. Okay, initial commit. Now it's there. Create a new repository. This has been created. My deployment actually took me a really long time and it was so much work, but I finally got it to work. What you have to do is that you have to set it up with GitHub, then the deployment is actually relatively straightforward. When I click on this, I should be able to visit it. I'm just gonna log in using the email that I created before. I'm just testing it. Now I am able to log in live on the website, and then I can do shopping at Apple and iPhone for $1,000 entertainment. You see how now it included all of these. Technically, I can use this as my app. Obviously, I can elaborate on the features, but literally, you built this for $2.50 with a developer, right? And so I thought that was pretty cool. You have just firsthand saw how Claude Dev works to build a live app. I think the biggest challenge of this project for me was the deployment, which took a little bit longer. And so if you're interested, next time I can create a video just on deployment. That's it for today. I hope that this will inspire you to take your first step to making your first app with AI. And if this video was helpful, please give me a like and hit the subscribe button to stay in touch. I promise you the next video will be even better than this one. See you next time.